Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning, everybody. Praise the Lord. I just thank the Lord for this wonderful time. I'm really blessed and favored. It's a beautiful moment to come live in Facebook. From last few days, we were discussing regarding church. I was speaking on a topic regarding church, which has been exampled as a plantation or a farm. In that particular category, I was discussing regarding fruits which has been produced inside the church or inside the farm or inside the plantation. So I was sharing about church. Church has been planted by God in such a way to bear fruits. So the first first way of bearing fruit was regarding Joseph, who was a fruitful guy. During his life, he gave his best fruit. Even in his loneliness, he produced the best fruit. He had intimacy with God. He was walking as per the word of God, and he produced fruit in his loneliness. And after being the second person in the kingdom of Egypt, he was faithful, bearing his best fruit, and he was acting the best way, even towards his enemies, even towards all the people. So the Bible says Joseph was a fruitful vine. He produced the best fruit. And the second thing I just discussed yesterday, which was that there are certain trees inside the farm not producing fruit. Hello. There are people inside the church. They are blessed. They are favored. They received everything good from God. They grew into a huge tree. But what's the use? They do not produce any fruits. We need to understand, if we do not produce fruit, obviously there are chances of God using the axe. But what happened? It so happened that it got one more year as a chance to produce some fruit. And the third category today I just want to discuss is from the book of Isaiah chapter 5 verse 1 onwards. In this particular passage, we can see it's a parable which has been told about the people of Israel. The people of Israel were the chosen people or God's beloved ones, or just God just showed his favor, mercy and love and gave all the provision to his chosen people. So in this particular passage, we can see what are the production which has been produced by his own chosen people. So let's turn our Bibles to Isaiah chapter 5 verse 1. Now let me sing of my greatly beloved Lord, a song for my beloved and about his vineyard, his chosen people. My greatly beloved had a vineyard on a very fertile slope. That's the promised land or Canaan. He dug it all around and cleared away its stone and planted it with the choicest wine. He built a tower in the center of it, and also he hewed out a wine vat in it. Then he expected to produce the choicest grapes, but it only produced worthless ones. Hello. God planted this vineyard. The vineyard represents the people of Israel, or they are the called ones, or they are the chosen people. God just chose them out of Egypt. God just chose them out of Mesopotamia and brought him as a vineyard to be fruitful, to produce something best. But what did it happen? It so happened it produced worthless ones. Hello? After being God's chosen people, after being blessed people, after receiving all the favors, after receiving everything required for nutrition, growth, and production, we see in this particular passage, they produced worthless one. Hello? Where was the vineyard established? It was established on a fertile slope. Hello? A well-watered place or a fertile place. God chose the best place for the people of Israel to grow, to produce something. God took the Israelites out of Egypt, brought them till Canaan. Why? The Bible says Canaan was a land where it was fruitful. So what did God do? He just picked them out, picked them from Egypt. They had to walk through the wilderness. They had to cross the Red Sea. They had to cross many a things. At last, they reached Canaan, or the fertile slope. After reaching to the fertile slope, he dug it all around, cleared the complete stones, planted the choicest wine. Hello, he planted the best wine. And what did he do? Now he is expecting for the best fruit. But what did it produce? But it produced some worthless ones. What does worthless mean? No, it means useless or junk grapes. Hello? Just think about the person who planted it. If you are that particular person, what will be your view? Hello? But in this particular passage, we can see God planted it and God is expecting the best produce and God is waiting. God did his best. But what did it happen? It produced something that is worthless, not even used for anyone. And the verse 3 says, and now says the Lord, O inhabitants of Jerusalem and men of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more could have been done for my vineyard that I have not done it when I expected it to produce good grapes? Why did it yield worthless? Hello? This is been told by God. After that, in the fifth verse, it says, so now let me tell you what I am going to do to my vineyard. I will take away the thorn hedges. It will be burning up. I will break its stone walls and will be trampling down and will be handling them too. The enemies, they will turn it into a wasteland and it will not be useful for any cultivation. Hello? You need to understand, if you are planted by God, if you have been chosen by God, if you have been favored by God, if you received all the best requirements for your livelihood, and even after that, you are not producing the best things, what will be the future? It so happened, the chosen people were handed to the enemies. They polluted them. They used them. That's the situation which Isaiah speaks. Hello. You have been called into the church. God planted you inside the farm or inside the plantation, and He gave all the resources required to you. He fertilized you. He equipped you. He showed His mercy upon you. But what do you produce? Are you being worthless? Or are you being acting junk? Hello, just think a while. If you produce junk, you need to understand, the complete plantation will be spoiled. Hello? The complete plantation can be spoiled. How tough and difficult way the planter planted it, gave the water, added complete nutrients, fertilizers. But at last it produces worthless grapes. What's the use of worthless grapes? This happened to the people of Israelites. What did they do? Why did the production change into worthless? Hello? It was because they had no trust in God. They had no dependency in God. They trusted on things which are worthless. If you trust something which is rendering worthless, you will obviously bear fruit which is worthless. Hello? What is the thing that is leading you? Is it something which is beneficial, or is it something which is worthless? The point we need to understand, if the people of Israelites had a dependency with God, if the people of Israelites had intimacy with God, if people of God or the people of Israelites would have accepted God as worthy, as a treasure, as a source, they could have produced something worthwhile. But they did not produce worthy ones. They produce worthless one. Why? Because they adapted to such a situation. They adapted to such a things. They adapted to such a things which are worthless, useless, a junk. And what did it produce? It produced junk fruits. It bore something which is worthless. After laboring so much, after giving everything, if somebody produces worthless thing, what will be the use of the particular tree? What will be the use of the particular vineyard? What will be the use of the particular chosen person? What will be the use of the particular called person? It's best to handle him or leave him to the worthless people. No, that's the thing. It says in chapter 5 verse 6, Isaiah chapter 5 verse 6, I will turn it into a wasteland. Hello. Now the vineyard is completely changed into a wasteland. Hello. I will turn it into a patch of weeds, untended, uncared, for thistles and thorns to take over. Hello. Why? If you are bearing something worthless, what will it happen? It will obviously produce unworthy things, unrequired things, unfruitful things. So there is thistles, thorns, weeds. And at last, what it says, I will also command the cloud not to rain on it. Hello. That means the supply which has been given by God will be trimmed. Hello. Right now, the church developed into an uncultivated land. So today, the Holy Ghost is reminding you to come back. Just have intimacy with God. Get relation with God so that you can produce something worthy. So the Bible says Jesus came into this world. John chapter 15 verse 1. I am the true vine. Whoever remains in me, they will produce the best vine. They will produce the best fruit. They can have intimacy with God. So Jesus came into this world to start a new relationship, a new beginning, a new life, a new birth. If you are back to Jesus, you can be worthy. You can produce something worthful one. But what happened to the Israelites? Even after receiving all the greatest blessings, even after receiving the law, even after receiving all the festivals, feast, priest, law, worship, temple, they received everything the best. At last, they received Jesus. But they did not care to have relationship with God. They did not care to have intimacy with God. Hello. Right now I am speaking to people. Start building relationship with God. Get intimate with God. You can be worthy. He can produce. He can change you into the best vineyard. He can cultivate you. He can fertilize you. He can give you all the nutritional benefits, so that you can produce the best. Hello. Don't produce wild fruit. Don't produce junk fruit. Don't produce worthless fruit. Don't insult the labor of the farmer. Don't insult God. Let's turn our Bibles to Deuteronomy chapter 32 verse 32 and 33. Deuteronomy chapter 32 verse 32 and 33. In this particular passage, Moses is giving an example between two categories. One about God, and the second thing he is pointing out regarding false God, true God and false God. What does it say? From 31. For their rock is not like our rock, even our enemies themselves judge this. Hello. Who is our rock? God is our rock. Jesus is our rock. But what about the false gods? They are not rock. That's the thing it says. What does it say? Thank you, Jesus. 32 verse 32. It says something like this. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. For their rock is nothing compared to our rock. Even our enemies say that. Hello. This is the word of Moses. This is a particular song of Moses, which represents about the enemies and about Israelites. True God and about false God. Israelites had the true God, but their enemies or the pagans, they had the false God. So what's the difference? When Israelites had Jesus as their rock, when Israelites had God as their rock and resource, comparing the enemies, they had a rock which was nothing for use. They depended on rocks, which had no use, which was not even a resource for them. But what happened? The enemies knew the greatness of Israel. The enemy knew the greatness of the God they serve. The enemies knew the resources they receive it from God. The enemies knew what all miracles did God do for the people of Israelites. When people compare, then starts the problem. Hello. If you compare your spirituality with other people, then there is obviously a problem. Then there will be a conflict. It so happened, Israelites used to grow, used to equip themselves, used to be beneficial, used to get all resources from God. But the enemies started comparing. They are getting blessed. They are receiving all the miracles. They are receiving everything what is necessary from heaven. They are receiving the best. Why don't we get it? So what did they plan to do? They plan to fight against them. Hello? Then the 32 verse says, they are a vine that comes right out of Sodom, who they are rooted in Gomorrah. Their grapes are poisonous grape. Their grape clusters bitter. Their wine is rattlesnake venom mixed with lethal cobra poison. Hello? This is what about the people who are trusting false God. Even though they are also a plantation, but what is their produce? They are a vine that comes out of Sodom. Hello? Sodom and Gomorrah. That was a particular place which God saw to destroy it. Why? Because that particular city produced something filth, junk, something worthless. They had homosexuality. They were doing everything wicked. They used to have parties. They used to have marriages. Thus, they used to be fleshy, 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 carnal men. Adapting all worthless things. They left the intimacy with God and started adapting things worthless, junk, unfruitful. And indirectly, they used to show God that being in our worthless entities, we are happy. We don't need God. We don't need law. We don't need anything regarding God. We have our own worthless carnality which can help us to grow. What did it happen? The eyes of the Lord watches all over the world. While watching, God saw Sodom and Gomorrah. What did it happen? God was so He planned to destroy the complete place. Why? Because they produced poison. Poison. Hello. What is the use of poison? Poison is such a thing. It can kill you gradually, slowly. Hello. Your worthless things are like poison. At first it will be very tasty. But in future days, it will kill you. So these people who were residing in Sodom and Gomorrah, they did not have God. They did not have fellowship with God. They didn't even like what the word of God says. They didn't even want to have fellowship with God. They thought they were gods. They thought what they do, that's their God. But indirectly they were acting worthless. So what did it happen? They began to grow. They thought we are the vine. We are rooted. And they produce grapes. Which type of grapes? Those grapes are poison. The grapes which were bitter. Hello. Just think what happened. A person who had fellowship with a man of God named Abraham. His cousin was Lot and his family. They were in a best intimacy. But what so happened? They just got split. And Lot chose to stay back or have his residence in Sodom and Gomorrah. It so happened Lot became the chairperson of that particular city, or else a counselor of that particular city. Wow. What so happened? In due course of time, he became the counselor of that particular city. But he knew what is God. He knew what is relationship with God. He knew what is the word of God. He knew who is the true God. He knew what he can do. But what did he do? He did not bother about anything. He just bothered to be in a city which was completely worthless. He knew the people were poisonous. He knew that people who were residing in Sodom and Gomorrah used to produce something which is bitter. They produced a fruit. They were root. They were growing the best. They had the best technology. They had the best food. They had the best everything. They had the best. But what it was completely worthless. God saw it. What did God do? God planned to destroy that particular city. Why? Because the people used to produce something. That's what 33 says. Their wine is rattlesnake venom mixed with lethal cobra poison. See. They produced some grapes. They produced some fruit. They produced something which is poisonous, venom. And in that particular city, this man of God, who? Lot. He was a man of God. He knew what is God. He knew what's the principles of God. He knew who is true God. He went into that particular city and became a councillor. Just think of it. You are a councillor of a worthless city. What will you do? You will start following the worthless things. Lot had a chance to get out. Even God's favor was upon Lot and his family. The angel of the Lord came, took hold of Lot, dragged him out of the city and told him to get out from this city. The city is worthless. But what did happen? Hello? What are you producing? What's the fruit which is coming out of you? You have been blessed. You grew so big, so great. What is the produce you give? Are you like Lot? We need to understand, right now the complete world is being ruled by some dead Greeks. I am sorry to say, democracy, the word democracy is a phrase which emerged from the ideas of Greeks or Greek philosophers. They just initiated the word democracy, people power. People will rule. We have a saying in, we have a proverb which says, too many cooks spoil the food. If the people work together to rule a country, what it will happen? So we need to understand, democracy is obviously against the Bible. The Bible says God is the supreme ruler. God is the creator. God is almighty. When you give influence towards democracy, what you are doing? You insult God. And you start people power, people choice, people suggestion. Whichever majority give their votes, they are the one elected. So what happens? Whatever the particular majority says, that's the thing they have to do. That was the situation of Lot in Sodom and Gomorrah. He was an influential person in that particular city. He was a counselor, but he could not do anything which was as per the word of God. In a pit, what can you do? You can be dirty, that's all. People are so loving and caring inside a pit. They love to be there. But what does a person who knew God, who has intimacy with God, his prayer would be, Lord, just take me out from this pit. That was a situation that happened to Joseph. Joseph was being led into the pit by his own brothers. But what did Joseph do? He just cried out to God, Lord, I don't want to be here. This is not my place. Okay, for time being, I am right now in the spirit, but Lord, just take me out. It's my prediction, it's not written in the Bible. Joseph was intimate with God, had fellowship with God, he had a time to spend with God, he knew who true God was. That's the reason God used to share visions, dreams of the future entities which are going to happen. That's the reason his brothers started disliking Joseph. But what did he do? God just took him out and they sold him to the Ishmaelites. They just took him and brought him till Egypt. Hello? And after Joseph being the second person in the Egypt, he did not have something poison. He did not have something bitter. He did not have something venom. He just gave his best fruit. Even when his brothers came, even when the people who just knocked Joseph badly, they were in front of him, he did not even insult them. He just gave the best administration he could give. Hello. So Deuteronomy chapter 32 verse 32 and 33, what does it say? They produced something which is bitter, killing others. Hello? They are acting like rattlesnakes. What do snakes do? Snake has a tendency to bite. And the body of snake is completely venomous. To whomever it bites, obviously it will die. So we need to understand, if you are residing with worthless things, you will be acting like snake. What is the quality of a snake? A snake is an animal. It goes crisscross, 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 crisscross. It never goes straight. No. We need to understand, the church is a plantation. The church is a farm. And after being inside the farm, after being inside the plantation, what is the produce? Fruit. What is the production you are releasing out? Is it something beneficial or is it poisonous? Is it something useful or is it bitter one? Is it something giving life or is it something that's giving death? That's the reason Jesus said, I came into this world to give you eternal life. Jesus came into this world to give you eternal life. And this eternal life is for you to be fruitful, producing something good, better, best. But if you run after worthless things, leaving God, leaving the intimacy with God, leaving fellowship with God, you will obviously produce something which is worthless. And worthless things will produce something bitter, something poisonous, something killing. Hello, you cannot do this particular thing inside the church. Inside the church, people are acting like wild fruit, worthless fruit, junk fruit. Stop that particular activity. You are not called to be church, to act junk, worthless. Illegal. God called you to be legal. God called you to be the best producing fruit. Right now, if you see the agricultural strategy of the world, what is the production from the agriculture which they give? They do grafting, illegal grafting, and whatever fertilizers they give to the particular plant or particular farm. It's completely illegal things. And what is the production? Production is very high. After eating such food items or such vegetables, such fruits, what is the ultimate result on our body? It releases cancer cells. It produces cancer. Hello? Whatever you sow, so shall you reap. What did God sow inside of you? God's word was sown inside of you. And you should produce something that is representing the God's word. Don't produce something that is worthless. Don't be poisonous. Come back to God. You have a rock. Who is Jesus Christ? He is your supply. He can give all your needs. He can give you the best fruit from within you. Let's turn our Bibles to Jeremiah chapter 2 verse 21. Jeremiah chapter 2 verse 21. What does it say? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Yet I have planted you, O house of Israel, as a choice vine, a completely fruitful seed. How then have you turned against me? Into degenerate shoots of foreign and wild wine. Hello. God planted the house of Israel into a choicest wine. But what did they do? They alienated themselves from God. Hello. You were a selected wine when I planted you. Completely reliable stock, and look how you have turned out a tangle of rancid growth, a poor excuse of a vine. Right now, people have life full of excuses, bahana, excuses. If you are alienated from God, you will have obviously excuses to say. That was the situation of the house of Israel. God planted them, but they started turning against God. Hello. After being inside the church, don't turn against God. Don't get alienated from God. Don't act like alien. Nowadays, people start forgetting God. Their minds are so scientific and developed, they are running after the aliens. People are forgetting God. They just develop their mind, body, soul into scientific possibilities and trying to know who are aliens. And the Bible completely says who aliens are. Look. Do you know what is the meaning of alien? Hello. Alien, belonging to a foreign country. A hypothetical or a fictional being from another world. Your brains are so scientifically packed that you are running after a thing which is not of this world. The Bible clearly says aliens are the fallen angels. Once upon a time, they used to be in God's arena, in God's kingdom. After they being polluted within themselves, they were being thrown out of the kingdom. So they lost all their better benefits. Right now, they don't have a place to reside. So God just kicked them off. When God kicked them off, they could not have their legal dominancy on earth. Why? Because fallen angels are spirits, and spirits do not have a legal authority on earth. Hello. If you don't have a visa and you plan to go to US, you will not be called legal citizen. You are illegal. So what is the criteria if you are illegal? Either they will throw you inside the jail, or they will throw you out of their country, or they have the rights to kill you. So that is the situation of the fallen angel. He does not have a place to reside. That's the reason he has his dominancy on air. He is a person who is residing on air. Alien. So we are the people residing on earth. And after being scientifically so knowledged, we are trying to know things which are on air. Hello. If you try to develop a quality to know what is on top of your head or on air, what will be the result you will be finding out? Worthless. That was the situation which happened to the people of Israelites. Did they do? They just started alienating from God, or they started to get away from God. And what did it happen? The verse 22 says, "For though you wash yourself with lye and use much soap, the stain of your guilty is still before me, and soiled and dirty, says the Lord." strongest soap, score your raw skin, the skin grease won't come out. Even God says, God lights. God told them to produce the best fruit, but they started alienating from God. Two situations such are worthless. They started to have friendship with things which they are worth, acting themselves. They are using the stop themselves. Hello. They bath thrice a day, four times a day. Won't come out. Jesus came into this world that he can give you the best soap through his blood. That's what Bible says. The blood of Jesus washes your sin. Hello. So that the skin appearance on our raw skin, it could be wrapped. God say, I can't stand to even look at you. When you are fully in, you are greased with sin. And you will just slip off, because grease is such a thing which won't allow you to stand. Wherever you go, wherever you touch, it will be revealing. The people who are inside the church, they are acting themselves. Hello. Your soap cannot wash your sins. You need a soap which is from heaven. And Jesus is that soap which came onto this earth, gave his complete blood to completely clean your kin, clean your sin, sorry, sin. And you have the word of God. Which to clean you. And you have the Holy Spirit. To clean you. If you are inside the church, you cannot adapt things which are worthless. You cannot produce something that is producing poison. You cannot produce something that is bitter. You cannot be like a snake, hissing and killing others. Don't be like a wild fruit. Come back to Christ. Come back to God. Start fellowship with God. Start your intimacy with God. You can produce the best fruit inside of you. Your carnality, your fleshiness, will be dominated by the power of God's Holy Ghost. Carnality, your fleshiness, will be dominated by the word of God. Your carnality, your fleshiness, And the blood of Jesus can clean you. So this is the point we need to understand. God chose you. God called you. God brought you inside the church. He wants you to be the best. If there is fleshiness, carnality inside of you, repent back to God. Ask God for His favor. Tell your situations. He is ready to forgive you. He is ready to develop you a newness inside of you. Tell to the Lord, Holy God, just help me. Lord, I want to be fruitful in life, Lord. Help me to know the word of God. Help to have intimacy with you, Lord. Help me to be dependent to you, Lord. Help me to know you, God. Help me to identify the truth which has been revealed in the word of God. Reveal me, give me your spirit, Lord, to purify myself, to clean myself, to be the best plantation, Lord, to be the best fruit, Lord, to be inside the church, giving life to everyone, giving joy to everyone, giving peace to everyone. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come to your presence, Lord. Thank you for this wonderful time. Just now we were discussing regarding church, which has been exampled as a plantation or a farm in which we should produce the best fruit. We should be like Joseph, Lord. We should be fruitful enough.